A card scraper or a cabinet scraper is a tool used by woodworkers to produce a very smooth surface. A piece of metal with a very fine burr on it scrapes a shaving off the surface, leaving a finish that's better than can be produced by sandpaper and much faster to do. Bookbinders typically use card scrapers to prepare edges before edge treatment, usually gilding. The first step in preparing or sharpening the scraper is to square off the top surface, usually with a file. The second step is to then polish the surface on the sides, then on the end to get rid of any fine scratches. And then the third step is to produce the fine burr, which is done with a burnisher. You first pull a hook off to the end and then bend that over. I normally sharpen the scraper in my garage with my woodworking and metalworking tools, but not everyone has that luxury. And there's no reason you can't use your bookbinding presses to do this work. The first step is to square up the edge of the scraper. Now I'm showing a specialty tool that's used for this job and also for what's called jointing saw teeth. But you can just get a block of wood and cut a groove in it, and that'll hold the file nicely. You just need something to keep the file square to the edge of the piece of metal. Now, most of the new scrapers that you'll buy, you don't need to do this step. But if you've got an old one, or you've made your own, then you will need to square up the edge. Now, these gooseneck scrapers, some people use those for scraping rounded foredges. And they're a bit harder to sharpen. The next step is to polish the flat sides and then the edge. I'm just going to use the 1200 grit on my sharpening station. There's nothing special about this. Usually about a dozen strokes is all that it takes to get a very nice finish, especially on a new scraper. I use a block to make sure that I get the edge square. Scrapers come in different shapes. The rectangle shape is probably the most common. Then the next most common is this shape with the curved edges, and that is by far my preferred scraper for doing the edges of books. And as I've already mentioned, the gooseneck scraper can be used on the rounded foredge. This is the technique I was taught for sharpening a scraper for woodworking. I was taught this decades ago, and I didn't change it at all for using a scraper for bookbinding. It sometimes feels like there's an infinite number of explanations on how to sharpen a card scraper, but I think the reality is that they all come down to these three steps: to square up the edge, to polish the edge, and to produce the burr. All the variations are minor variations on those three steps. The final step is to create the burr. I'm going to use a tool that's specifically made for this. It's made of very hard steel, much harder than the steel of the scraper. But you can also use a high quality screwdriver. Use a drop of any light machine oil to lubricate the surfaces and make everything run smoothly. I always start by burnishing the edges and pulling a slight burr out in the direction of the flat surface. Not everyone does this. Some people skip this step and they still can produce a good burr, but I think I produce a better burr when I do this step first. So when I'm doing that, I'm sort of pulling it over the edge. I'm keeping the burnisher flat, but putting the pressure on the edge. And I'm trying to pull it away from the surface slightly. So I'm sort of trying to draw that burr out. As I mentioned, there seems to be a lot of different ways to sharpen a scraper, but in reality, they're all pretty much the same. The biggest variation is on producing the burr. A lot of people don't burnish the sides like I'm doing right now first. They just go straight to producing the burr that sticks out. I think a lot of variation in the ways of sharpening a scraper comes from the wide variation in the steels that they're made of. If you're using a softer steel, you probably don't need to burnish the edges like this first to get a nice substantial burr. But I've always used quite hard steel scrapers. The advantage of the harder steel scraper is the burr will last longer. Typically, the scraper with the two curved edges, I'll get two book edges out of that before I have to redo the burr. Now that I've burnished the sides, I'm going to produce the burr. I'll put it in some sort of clamp or vise. And then I'm going to run the burnisher back and forth perpendicular to the sides. And I'm going to do that 4 or 5 times normally. I end up doing it more in the video just because I'm demonstrating. For these first 4 or 5 strokes with the burnisher horizontal, I'm just going to go back and forth. But then I'm going to do it 4 or 5 times with the burnisher tilted to the side about 5 degrees. And then I'm going to draw it across the surface and try and draw the burr out. So here's the 4 or 5 with it flat and back and forth, and then I'm going to tilt it about 5 degrees and to start drawing it out. I'll draw it out in the direction that I want the burr to go and in the direction I'm tilting the burnisher. So now I'll swap and go in the other direction. So I'll end up with a burr on each side of the burnet of the card scraper. So you'll end up with 4 surfaces or 4 edges that you can use for scraping the edge of a book. You'll be able to feel the burr with your fingernail, and you might be able to just see it, but it is really, really small. In the diagrams that I drew, it is greatly exaggerated, but you'll be able to feel it. If you can't feel it, then I would start again at the polishing, polish again, and then burnish. The burnisher that I'm using is made by Veritas. It's really good in that for doing the tighter curves, especially the gooseneck scraper, it's hard to get enough pressure when you're going around that tight curve. And this burnisher is sort of a teardrop shape, so you can rotate it so that you're using the pointy part of the teardrop shape and you get more pressure. But for the flat surfaces, you get a nice, more even pressure with the wider, flatter surface. Veritas is a Canadian company that makes wonderful woodworking tools. A number of these are useful for bookbinding. As well as the burnisher, these card scrapers are theirs as well. The tool rest on my hand cranked grinder is made by them, and the green honing compound I use on my strops is also from them. I'm not going to have time to fit in music today, which I guess means I don't have to deal with media companies claiming they own the rights to the melody of music written over 500 years ago, so I'm not going to miss that, but I do miss the music. To test that you've got a good burr, you can use a piece of wood. You should be able to produce fine little curly shavings If you just get dust, then the burr isn't sufficient. To use the scraper, wrap your fingers around each end and put your thumbs in the center and slightly bend the scraper and lean it over at about 45 degrees. Sort of go down in a sort of curving motion, so there's a little less pressure when you start and a little pressure as you come off the edge of the book. As always, if you've found this video useful, please hit the like button. If you want to be notified about my future videos, please hit the subscribe button. And until next time, cheerio.